Sure. We are in the process of commissioning the plant. We've got through C4 commissioning, which means that each component in the whole processing plant has run with ore at the required capacities. The issue now is to get the whole plant running stably for a period of 48 hours, producing at the design specification in terms of quantity and quality, and we're hoping that'll be imminent. We've been able to export the concentrate that we've processed and produced during the commissioning process all the way through to Gerald Metals in Kampala, which is terrific. You know, that was kind of the last link in the chain in terms of de-risking the entire project. So now it's a question of just methodically and carefully going through each of the steps, each of the processes, refining them, getting your recoveries up. The front end throughput is fine, and one of the issues we actually ironically had is trying to keep the grade down, in that the miners were very anxious to feed us grades that would have flooded our plant. So a gravity concentration plant doesn't like you to throw too much material at it. It wants just the right amount, and we've been able to balance that. So that's coming through very nicely, and the grade on the concentrate is absolutely perfect. You know, to see it on the tables, which is the final kind of stage, you have this beautiful putty pink area, which is the tin concentrates are very easy to set your cut points, and it all comes out. So it's now just getting the team up and running, getting them familiar with the equipment, getting our logistics lines going a little more smoothly. It's just that incremental process of where you move from a C4 commissioning through to a C5, which is where you take control of the whole plant. Well, I think the DRC has an enormous number of challenges aside from just the mining code, you know, but any jurisdiction has its own share of challenges. I was talking to somebody who was trying to put together a gold mine in Arizona, and they've been trying to get permitting for a whole number of years. So, you know, each area has its own challenges. The DRC has grades that very few other places in the world have at the kind of level that is available in the DRC. And I think focus has largely been on the traditional mining areas, particularly around the Lubumbashi area. We kind of a new kid on the block out on the east, joining the likes of Kibali and Banro. And I think we still remain on the periphery. I think there's still a huge amount that can still be discovered and uncovered. And the people here are extraordinary. They've got a work ethic that is absolutely remarkable. They've got a hunger for knowledge. They want to learn more and more about what they're doing. I'll give you a small example. We've got a control room operator sitting up and managing our entire plant. This guy taught himself English, and he did it via the internet, and he had to do it after 12 o'clock at night because otherwise the airtime was too expensive. Taught himself English. He arrived at our site as a translator, and sort of gradually people recognize somebody who's skilled and has competence. He's now driving our entire plant. You know, there he sits with six screens in front of him, managing the plant. So there's this incredible wealth of human capacity, of people who can and will do things, and will do things great. One just has to give them an opportunity and point them in the right direction, and you can achieve extraordinary things. Well, these events are always great in that all the players in the industry are in one place at one time. So it's very efficient to be able to have a host of meetings of people with whom you deal with, or people with whom you possibly should be dealing with, and also to update other players in the industry as to where you're at, what your challenges are, and just generally be part of what is an incredibly vibrant mining community.